I think that means a lot for this program in the city of San Diego.
As you can see, there are plenty of Aztecs fans out here in Houston enjoying the moment, enjoying this run. I'm glad there's some libations going around because yes. They're probably a little more relaxed than I am.
Well, I can't wait for this game. It is a rematch of the game against UConn, when the Aztecs played in the Sweet 16, the Kawhi Leonard team, back in 2011. Aztecs lost to UConn that day. We're hoping for a different result coming up tonight here in Houston, Jake.
And UConn's been amazing, John. They've beaten everybody by double digits. Nobody really giving the Aztecs a chance in this game. But I am done doubting this team. I've doubted them many times before this, and they keep winning, and they keep winning, and they keep winning. They just need one more, my friend.
Yeah, and the Aztecs has a defense that can handle this UConn offense. I don't foresee UConn winning by double digits. I foresee another single-digit game. And a stat I shared with you on the drive over, in the last three games, the Aztecs have given up zero fast break points against teams that want to push the ball.
And if they can play into their advantage by keeping this game close, the Aztecs have played close games. They've won their last two games by 2 points. Yep. UConn's won every game by double digits. Excuse me. Let's hope this is a close game, Marcus.
Yep. We could go on forever, but we know that you and Carlo and Heather have to have some time.
We appreciate it, fellas. Thank you so much.
You know what's so fun about watching this team is watching them build that momentum in the second half.
Right.
So it's one of those teams that you can almost skip the first half, come in at the second half, because sometimes it's a different team coming back after whatever pep talk after the locker room.
Yep. It's kind of like the Aztecs revenge tour, though, here, isn't it? Right, John? You're still up, so I've got to ask you.
He's anxious. He's ready to get to the arena, you guys. He's like, are we clear?
Let's go.
I know, but it's the Aztecs revenge tour. Creighton from last year, UConn from the Sweet 16. Little extra motivation for what is now a legitimate national program.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Coach Dutcher has said, we're not a one undone. This is a program that belongs in the national conversation, and this year has proven that.
Yeah, and legitimate is the right word, Carlo. You talk about what this run will mean for this team. It's amazing. You know, people used to think of San Diego State as the team that was good in the Mountain West. Oh, that's the place Kawhi went. Oh, that's where Steve Fisher coached. No, now this is a national title contender and hopefully a national title champion.
Yeah, and it's also nice that we are the team that now everybody's hearing about. We remember the Butlers, the Loyola, La Jolla of Chicago teams that have gone long ways in NCAA tournaments, and finally it's the Aztecs' turn.
It's our turn. It's our year. Jake and John, thank you guys so much. Live coverage from Houston.
Hey, are we clear?
You played it. I'm going to let you go. Yeah, you can go.
We'll let you go. I think the big thing about this game, too, is that the Aztecs are just going to have to play how they've always played. And we were kind of talking about this before the show, is don't do anything crazy. Don't do anything special. You know who you are, right? You're a defensive-minded team, and the game is going to come to them in the second half, and I think that's what we see. And like Jake and John said, keep the game close. Make it tough for UConn. UConn has a ton of talent, but the thing is, you got to be scrappy. You got to be mean. It's got to be an ugly game. Guys got to be flying all over the floor, and I think that's the best chance at San Diego State has.
They're a veteran team, so they're a little bit older and they're a little bit more mature.
Right.
And that's how, like in the FAU game, they got 8 offensive rebounds in a row. They start to wear teams out, and they know who they are.
Mm-hmm.
They're Brian Dutcher's team.
Right.
They know who they are and what they're doing.
Mm-hmm. Defense. Ooh, let's go. I'm sorry. I'm excited as well. I'm a little nervous. I got to shake this off.
We'll let you go get back to work. I'm going to go over here. We'll usher you off.
All right. Let's go, Aztecs.
We know you're busy. Go, Aztecs.
Marcus, thank you. Right now, the campus at SDSU is buzzing with everyone from students to staff and alum showing off their Aztec pride, and the merch is flying off the shelves at the student store.
CBS 8's Anna Laurel has been there all day long soaking up the excitement. Anna, is it still just vibing right now?
Yes, you guys, as the kids say, it is lit out here. The party is just getting started at Viejas Arena. The doors open at 5 p.m. for the free watch party. And as excited as this crowd is, the party all day has actually been at the bookstore.
From all over the city and beyond, people flocked to San Diego State's bookstore today.
Let me know if I can help you find a size.
The line to buy Aztec merch wrapped all the way around the store.
I think this is the end.
I think
thing.
Yeah. Okay.
Today we met longtime fans.
I'm a fan because it's, you know, I'm an alumni.
Students who've hopped on the bandwagon.
We've gone to a couple games, but definitely a little bit bandwagon. I mean, when we watched the game yesterday, we like went crazy. Like, it was insane.
And brand new, soon to be lifelong fans like the Press family from LA.
Our son just got admitted to the school, so we're super excited to buy mom and dad sweatshirts.
Aiden decided to come to SDSU this weekend.
So you decided on Saturday, did it have anything to do with the March Madness?
Yeah.
Did it?
No, it did not.
Okay. But now they're all in.
The buzzer beater was crazy. I saw the video of the student section of all the SDSU fans. I got really hyped, so I'm really excited to go to games next year.
I mean, after this wild tournament run, who isn't all in?
The whole fam comes over, watches it. We're all like on the edge of our seats.
So now everyone's on the bandwagon just in time. If we win tonight, they all say they'll be back here at the bookstore tomorrow to get national champ gear.
Every step further, you just go, wait, seriously? We're moving on to the 16th? No, and then it's the 8th, and then it's the final four.
And no matter what, go Aztecs.
This is what movies are made of. You know, that would be just a story that you go, oh, that's such a fairy tale kind of story, but no, it's really happening.
And it is happening, you guys. We believe that we will win. Guys, back to you in the studio.
Well, Anna, I'm just looking at the crowd. The game time's over 2 hours away. Look at that line. How many people do you think are out there?
I believe that we will win.
Oh, yeah. They are ready, you guys. Now, they are starting to close down the streets around Viejas Arena. So if you don't want to come down here and deal with that, of course, you can watch it right here on CBS 8. Coverage starts at 5:30. We're pre-gaming right now, though.
I know. Makes me want to jump up and down with
them. I get goosebumps with that cheer. Remember the early days of the show when it was novel, when Steve Fisher was building this program up to what it is now? They didn't have this kind of fan support, and then all of a sudden it became a thing in town at Viejas, and it was cool, and it's still very cool. And that cheer, that cheer, it's fantastic.
People tried to claim it as their own from different schools. I'm like,
get out of here. Go away.
All right, so you can understand the classroom's probably a little quiet because some professors are canceling class so you can watch the game.
Dana Littlefield tweeted out to my students, no class on Monday night. You know why? Go Aztecs.
Lewis Wiener also tweeted, I'm in Houston, so my Tuesday class will not happen, LOL.
Lou used to work with us here. We knew that was going to happen.
Yeah, we've known he's been in Houston for a couple days now, enjoying all this.
Soaking it up. And, of course, it seems like everyone is rooting for the Aztecs because they are. But check this out. The city of San Diego lit up Balboa Park in red in honor of the game, tweeting out, we're behind you 100%. Go Aztecs.
So just so you know, you get to watch the game right here on CBS 8.
Pre-game coverage on CBS 8 starts at 5:30. Tip-off is set for 6:20, so just got a little time to get settled in and relax. Get your snacks, get your fans, get your friends over. Yeah.
Let's get it going. All right. Let's have some fun. Glad you're with us. It is Monday. It's Aztec Monday.
It's Championship Monday.
There we go. Yes.